In old Puerto Rico, a long time ago, there lived a poor farmer they called Señor Joe. Now, Joe was so poor, he had little to eat. To him, even moldy old cheese was a treat. So one holiday eve, having little to give, he wrapped up some cheese for his wife, Doña Viv. He just tied the bow on the big cheesy ball when he heard his wife's footsteps outside in the hall. As she entered the kitchen, Joe, taken aback, hid his gift just in time neath the oven's third rack. Joe sighed with relief, then he hugged Viv and said, "Que sueño, I am sleepy, I am going to bed." Well, the moment he left, Viv broke into a grin. Then she pulled from the cupboard a rusty old tin. Inside was some cornmeal she'd planned far ahead to use to bake Joe a surprise loaf of bread. Doña Viv was excited. Her timing was right. She could let the bread bake in the oven all night, which she did, 'cause she wasn't the least bit aware that the cheese wrapped in paper was also in there. Viv and Joe slept like logs, but awoke the next morn to the stink of burnt paper, burnt cheese, and burnt corn. The cheese was on fire, the bread belching smoke. What an unkindly sight for these kindly old folk. "Que pasa?" Joe shouted. "The cheese was for you. My bread," wailed his wife, "was a gift for you too." They doused out the fire using big water jugs. Then they both sat with sad, tearful looks on their mugs, till the smoke had died down and their crying had too, and then Viv said, "We both did the best we could do." Then they kissed one another, not saying a peep, and they stumbled to bed and went straight back to sleep. Now, don't think for a moment this story ends here, 'cause young Olga, an orphan, was strolling quite near. And because she was hungry, she snuck in and ate a small bite of the cheese goop and cried, "This is great!" Then she wolfed down some more and took off down the street, shouting, "Mira, come try this incredible treat!" The neighbors all tried some, and then with a roar, they rushed, mouths wide open, to Joe and Viv's door. Well, Viv and her husband awoke to this din and looked on amazed as the people poured in. "Bake more," they kept chanting. "We need a new stash. Bake more right now and we'll pay you with cash." "Te ayudo, I'll help you," was Olga's reaction. And Viv said, "Let's give her a piece of the action." And so this odd trio became renowned bakers, the pueblo's most popular cheese and bread makers. Viv, Olga and Joe gained both fortune and fame, and Cheesybreadville was declared the town's name. But the Cheesybread partners stayed humble, you know. They counted their blessings, along with the dough. And despite all they earned, a prodigious amount, they never forgot that good thoughts are what count. And they also learned this, but please pardon the pun, when giving a present, make sure it's well done.